Good day, ladies and gentlemen. Usually I didn't like to do another video like this again, where I'm just sitting on this lovely couch and talking to you about things, but I think after the release of the 1804 Ubuntus, you've seen enough desktops and I just wanted to finish this video. It's been a while and I need to do this because it's killing me. The whole story started with a post on Facebook from Joe Collins, you might know from Easy Linux, and if you're eager enough to follow such a small channel like me, I suppose you're already following Joe Collins for good reasons. Good man, if you see this, shoutouts to you, love you man. He argued about non-matching GTK and Qt themes in GNOME environments especially, and you can read for yourself. I said something like, don't make a video about this, I want to do is, I went into the Arch Wiki, saw massive portions of possible solutions, looked into vanilla Ubuntu GNOME, looked into vanilla Debian GNOME, looked into OpenSUSE, and then this happened.
I spent more than two weeks figuring this shit out to find out that these freaky enterprise dudes from Nuremberg Franconia put in some packages, made them standard. Nothing here is tweaked. You can look in all the settings. Qt5, it says standard. Qt4, it says standard. And it works. So what is your problem? I'm really pissed off. I wasted 2 weeks.
This was originally the reason I didn't want to make videos like this again, because I was just losing my shit. That's exactly it. I said to myself, script it, record it, everything will be fine. No, it took me 5 weeks. Okay, OpenSUSE is a distribution that is rather old, that is very well reviewed, but the tenor of all the reviews seems to be, it's a good distro, it's just not for me. I looked into it. I already liked that KDE seems to be the more supported and more encouraged variant of this distribution, which pleases me because I'm a classical KDE guy. You remember the Debian XFCE video? My spouse is now running GNOME and she loves it because it works perfectly for her. I, on the other hand, I'm a guy who needs to have more options than necessary, and I can live with lots of things shining into my face at once and wanting my care and love. I can deal with that. Therefore, I am a KDE guy, and KDE Connect sells me. But I don't want to talk about KDE. I want to talk about OpenSUSE, Leap 15. You can also download a rolling release version. That's Tumbleweed. That's more or less the same, except it's rolling. Yeah, what can I say to you? The installer is the best installer I've experienced this far. It might be a little off-putting to newbies, but I like that it somehow sees what you might want to do, guides you to the right way, but it always gives you this advanced option. You can choose between do you like a GNOME environment, do you like a KDE environment, but then there's this one button that's especially for me, custom. I love to have a custom option. Usually I'm the guy who takes a net install of Debian or a net install of Ubuntu, does a minimalistic as possible installation and puts everything like Lego bricks on top of each other to get the OS I want to. And that was quite okay, because if I had chosen GNOME or KDE, I'd have a very nice desktop environment perfectly configured with the common GNOME and KDE programs like KML, Evience, and what they're all told, that I don't use. I'm mostly a Firefox guy, part-time Falcon guy, part-time Chromium guy, and I don't use any other email client than Thunderbird. We're back at NitBacteria territory again, I know, and judge me all you want, but to know that I won't have to install, to update, and then to sudo apt or sudo pacman, or in this case sudo zipper, install everything I want, that I can take the big portion of the work I have to do right away from the installation, is great. Also, I noticed that it uses BetterFS for the root partition and XFS for home partition. And as I stated before, I'm not a developer, I'm not a IT engineer. There might be benefits, there might be disadvantages. I've read it up on Wikipedia. I'm used to working with ext4. ext4 has worked with me, and I think BetterFS and XFS will work as well. That's just a little detail of care they put into it. And a little detail of care is the modus operandi here, because I've noticed you have this huge ISO. It's almost DVD size. Everything that's on this ISO, it's the level of thought and care I'd like to see in a Windows release. No, you didn't mishear me, and I didn't go crazy for a moment. Everything is so good, fine-tuned, patched, and so on. It's greatness. And Yast is, you can do everything that you can do with Yast with a little knowledge and a little tinkering inside a terminal. But it's really nice to have something graphical here. Doesn't matter if you're on GNOME, doesn't matter if you're on KDE, it works on Qt, it works on GTK, that you have a massive collection of graphical user interfaces that help you to administrate your program above the system settings that you get with your graphical desktop environment. And that's a great thing to have. Me, as a casual user, I'm underusing it. Of course I do. I don't have to put 50 laptops, machines, pies in a network row. I'm just this casual user. And this is where I have to repeat the tenor I was citing myself. This is a great distribution. It's just not for me. Big surprise, I know. But let me tell you a story. Pardon me. I've been following OpenSUSE on Twitter for some time now. I see what they do. I see what they're aiming for. I see what systems they encourage to build. They are working environments, enterprise environments. At the beginning of the year, I work at a really big hospital. We were told that all the paperwork in the nursing progress will be gone, and we got two new computers. It's on a mobile desk, you can drive around with it, huge energy cell, nice things, and also all our machines were upgraded from Windows 7 to Windows 10. Yay. About a week ago, a very lovely, intelligent lady from the IT department came to us and asked for, are there any problems? Are there any suggestions? And I told her, it works as it should have, but tell me, do we really need Windows 10? Because I don't know who created this, but all the other apps we have besides our GUI for our database are web-based applications. The program you need to view X-ray images, the programs you, all the documents are usually PDFs or XMLs. Even the program we need to do buy our drugs from our in-house drugstore, it's all internet-based, so it runs on Firefox, it runs on Chromium, it runs on got a little tummy sensation there, don't know why. So. Joke question, but the core is serious. Why do we need Windows 10? Why don't we use something like SUSE? And she knew what I was talking about, and her face lit up at the moment. And I can see this work. No problem. If you need to have good business PCs that you need to do your email, your office writings, write your letters, be connected to all your colleagues via different work groups, I can see this work in SUSE, of course, and in OpenSUSE as well. OpenSUSE is the oldest Linux tech company in the world and still the second biggest. Keep doing what you do. Thank you for the ride. I didn't stick with it. That's okay. But if you do, dear ladies and gentlemen out there watching, please tell me in the comments. I'd be really pleased to hear your story, because I'm a small channel. I'm not a tech guy. I'm a casual user. I'm just doing these YouTube videos because I need something creative to get my to get my feeling of having accomplished something. And I really like to hear from you, even if we might disagree. To all the other watchers out there, I hope you're not too embarrassed and that I showed roughly no footage in this video, but I think you know how a KDE desktop looks. You know it. What shall I do again? I know distro reviews get really, really good clicks. What shall I do? Open a simple screen recorder and show you another tickling around in menus and this is great, this is great. No, I've had enough time doing this. I didn't know why it didn't happen, why it didn't work until now. I think this format suits me. It might suit you. You can look at KDE and GNOME desktops all you want. And also tell me what you think of this format. And last but not least, shout outs to Mara Voltage, a band from my hometown, Regensburg, Bavaria, Germany, who provided the music for this video. Thanks for your participation. And you, thank you for watching. Until the next time, auf Wiedersehen.